The bitter industrial dispute between unionists and building giant Grocon is showing no signs of slowing down. Grocon's chief executive has agreed to meet with union members and Fair Work Australia in Melbourne this afternoon, but things are now heating up in Sydney as well, with protesters being given a Supreme Court order that bans them from going near a building site. TEN's Melinda Yusufora is there and she joins us now live. Mel, the workers appear to be ignoring this order though.
Ron, this certainly shows no sign of calming down in Sydney or Melbourne today. Well, this morning at about 5 a.m, workers started rallying again, blockading the front of the Grocon site here in Sydney CBD. A Supreme Court order had been posted on the front door of their site banning any union members from coming within 100 metres of that building. Well, they decided then that would be the perfect place for them to set up their blockade this morning. They posted their banners and their flags and have been chanting right throughout the morning. They say, though, that they understand that they have been labelled as louts and troublemakers and lazy in some parts of the media, but they are firm and say that this is a fight of national significance, that 62 construction workers have been killed in work sites right across the country in various different sites, and that safety standards haven't improved.
We've seen two accidents that have taken place here in Pitt Street where material has landed in the street. It could have killed anybody. Our concern is just not about workers, it's also about the general public.
Mel, if this meeting between the Grocon boss and Fair Work Australia actually goes ahead, what will be discussed? What's going to happen?
Okay, well, this was brokered by the Workplace Relations Minister, Bill Shorten. Grocon management and the top brass of the CFMEU have decided to meet. That'll happen in Melbourne later this afternoon. They're hoping to come to some kind of negotiation to end this sort of stalemate, which has seen kind of anger and violence bubbling up throughout the capital cities around the country. Though management on both sides say they're not very confident that they'll reach any sort of agreement today. And the members we've spoken to here this morning say they have no intention of stopping their protest anytime soon.